Hello. Diarrhea is a common problem in many animal species, especially young calves, small puppies, and even foals, and even sometimes in the adult animals. So, and many a times we are faced with what to administer, how to administer, what will be the dose. So in our today's talk, we discuss about the antidiarrheal drugs. Friends, I am Professor Govindarayan Purohit, and I will discuss about the antidiarrheal drugs. First, we will discuss the pharmacology, and then we will discuss the common drugs that can be used for small calves, for adult cattle, for small pups, for foals, for adult horses, and that will give you some insights on the antidiarrheal drugs. So, without wasting time, come on, let us discuss what are the antidiarrheal drugs. Now, first, let us discuss what is diarrhea. Abnormal increase in the frequency, fluidity, or volume of feces due to excessive fecal water content is known as diarrhea. It's a symptom of many diseases, maybe bacterial, maybe parasitic, maybe due to other reasons, and it can be caused by even by pathophysiological processes, increased osmotic particles, fluid ion secretion, mucosal permeability breakdown, altered motility of the intestine. Right? Now, here are the antidiarrheal drugs. The antidiarrheal drugs have been classified into non-specific antidiarrheal drugs and the specific chemotherapeutic agents. The non-specific antidiarrheal drugs include the gastrointestinal protectants and adsorbents like kaolin, pectin, bismuth salts, activated charcoal, cysteamine, and then the anti-motility drugs, the opioids, tincture of opium, codeine, diphenoxylate, loperamide, and then the anti-secretory and anti-inflammatory drugs like salicylic acid derivatives, sulfasalazine, mesalazine, anticholinergics like atropine, hyoscine, miscellaneous NSAIDs, glucocorticoids, clonidine, octreotide, and racidotril. Then miscellaneous drugs like tannic acid, cachechol, carboxy, methylcellulase. And then the specific chemotherapeutic agents like antibiotics, like streptomycin, neomycin, ampicillin, succinyl, sulfathiazole, enrofloxacin, nitrofurazone, furazolidone, right? Then non-specific antidiarrheal drugs, we discuss about the gastrointestinal protectants and adsorbents. They coat the mucosal surface or absorb the toxins. And then kaolin is a hydrated aluminium silicate used as an antidiarrheal and absorbent, often combined with pectin. And pectin is a carbohydrate polymer, absorbent and protective properties used along with kaolin. Then there is bismuth subsalicylate, anti-secretory. It has got anti-secretory and antibacterial activity. It is metabolized to bismuth and salicylate. But the disadvantage is it causes black stools, and it can cause salicylate toxicity in cats and nephrotoxicity, especially with aminoglycosides. Then activated charcoal is an excellent adsorbent used for poisonings. Then anti-motility drugs, like they increase the intestinal tone and segmental activity, like opioids. They reduce the propulsive movements, diminish the secretions, and enhance the absorption, and inhibit acetylcholine release. Diphenoxylate, it is a synthetic opioid that slows intestinal contractions. It is more potent than morphine and can cross the blood-brain barrier. Then loperamide, it is a synthetic opioid that acts on microreceptors with anti-secretory effects. It is more potent and longer duration than diphenoxylate. But it should be used with caution in some dog breeds and even in horses. In some dog breeds, they are sensitive to collies and shelties. They are sensitive and may develop problems with the use of loperamide. Then include anti-secretory and anti-inflammatory like salicylic acid derivative, sulfasalazine for inflammatory bowel disease, is hydrolyzed in the colon to release 5-aminosalicylic acid, which is anti-inflammatory. Then anticholinergics, they reduce the gut secretion and motility like atropine and hyoscine. Then specific chemotherapeutic agents, antibiotics for infectious diarrhea like aminoglycosides, penicillin, sulfonamides, nitrofurans, quinolones. This use should be judicious and based on culture and sensitivity testing wherever possible, or it should be the second line of choice. The important consideration in diarrhea is the fluid and electrolyte replacement. Oral rehydration solutions for mild to moderate dehydration and intravenous rehydration for severe dehydration or when oral intake is insufficient or is not possible by the animal. Then miscellaneous antidiarrheal drugs, what we call the intestinal astringents, they precipitate proteins, form a protective layer like tannic acid and catechu, and others include carboxymethyl cellulose, psyllium, polycarbophyll, the fiber supplements increase the viscosity.
Now we talk about diarrhea in different animal species.
First we talk of diarrhea in small cows. Generally, calf scours occurs in young cows, which is also known as neonatal diarrhea. It's a common issue in dairy and beef cows. The treatment depends on the hydration status, severity and the underlying cause. So one should try to replace the fluids. Moderate to severe cases, IV fluids like ringer lactate, normal saline with dextrose, and one should add bicarbonate if acidosis is present. Antibiotics should only be used if bacterial infection is suspected, just like E. coli, Salmonella, and one can use enrofloxacin at the rate of 5% at the rate of 2.5 mg. Per kg intramuscular sulfadimidine bolus can be given orally, 100 mg per kg orally, oxytetracycline 10 mg per kg intramuscular, and for clostridial diarrhea, bloody stools with sudden death, one can use penicillin and metronidazole intravenously. Use amoxicillin trihydrate 10 mg per kg every 12 hours to control E. coli, and one should use the antidiarrheals and probiotics such as neocaolin or the lactobacillus powder or saccharomyces powder available commercially. Diarrhea in calves can generally treated with the sulfadimidine tablets as are shown here, and sometimes when calves develop coccidiosis, they will have bloody diarrhea and will have severe dehydration. So these are the recommendations for use of anticoccidial drugs. Sulfadimidine 100 mg per kg orally for 5 days, Amprolium 10 mg per kg orally for 5 to 7 days, Toltraglural 15 mg per kg orally single dose, and supportive therapy like electrolytes and vitamin A and B complex, because coccidiosis leads to vitamin deficiency. Prevention Monensin, Lasalosid, they can be used. Now, a common common herb that is herbal preparation that is used in diarrhea is the diarrhea powder, which contains catechu and many other herbal things. Sometimes cattle develop chronic diarrhea, and adult cattle, when there is a chronic diarrhea, then what should you suspect? If the diarrhea is chronic in calves, then dehydration
should be suspected. If there is Jones disease, there will be chronic diarrhea, weight loss.
There is no cure. Chronic salmonellosis, there is persistent diarrhea and fever with abortion. Antibiotics like ceftiofur, enrofloxacin can be used. And then there is bovine virus diarrhea. It will cause mucosal disease, and supportive therapy and vaccination is the answer. Coccidiosis, there will be bloody diarrhea, and Amprolium, sulfadimidine, toltraxural are the drugs of choice. Then diarrhea in horses, treatment of diarrhea in newborn foals less than 1 month old, fluid therapy, equine oral rehydration 2 to 4 liters per day, or one can use the human virus 50 to 100 ml per kg per day, fresh mare's milk, frequent small feedings, and in severe dehydration, lactated drinker solution plus dextrose 10 to 20 ml per kg per hour intravenous. Plasma transfusion if Ig levels are 800 mg per deciliter. Then antibiotics, use antibiotics like ceftiofur 2.2 mg per kg intramuscular IV, or then amoxicillin 20 mg per kg, metronidazole 15 mg per kg. Avoid unnecessary antibiotics use unless sepsis or bacterial infection is confirmed. Then one can use GI protectants and probiotics, sucralfate 20 mg per kg, omeprazole 4 mg per kg, equine probiotics 10 to 20 gram per day. And if parasites are suspected, if strongyles or cryptosporidium are suspected, fenbendazole 10 mg per kg into 5 days, clortrazuril 5 mg per kg SID for cryptosporidium. Then anti-inflammatory like flunixin, meglumin 1.1 mg per kg, polymyxin B, it's a endotoxin binder, and 6000 international unit per kg IV twice a day are suggested. Then diarrhea in adult horses, fluid and electrolyte therapy is suggested. Mild cases, one can use oral therapy, and severe cases, one should go for lactated Ringer solution 50 to 100 ml per kg per day IV, and hypertonic saline 7.2%, 4 mg per kg IV is suggested if rapid expansion is in shock. Then antibiotics, clostridium cases, metronidazole and ceftiofur, metronidazole 15 mg per kg, ceftiofur 2.2 mg per kg IV or IM. Avoid antibiotics unless a confirmed bacterial cause, as they can worsen colitis in horses. Then one can use the protectants, 20 mg sucralfate, 20 mg per kg, omeprazole, equine probiotics, and for endotoxemia management, as suggested earlier, one can use clonixin, polymyxin, and then for for parasite control, strongyles or and ivermectin 0.2 mg per kg orally once, or fenbendazole 10 mg per kg orally for 5 days. For horses, you need to administer the medicines through the stomach tube. When to suspect specific causes in horses, say if there is a severe watery diarrhea, one should suspect salmonella, and one should go in for culture and PCR. Clostridial colitis, there is a bloody diarrhea and endotoxemia, to go for toxin assay. Rotavirus, explosive diarrhea, dehydration. Parasitic diarrhea, weight loss, chronic colitis, one should go for fecal egg count. And NSAID-induced colitis, there is a history of NSAID use, go for ultrasound and biopsy. Now, diarrhea in dogs, the adsorbents and protectants like kaolin pectin 1 ml per kg body weight orally every 6 hours, bismuculin, bismuth subsalicylate, pet mankind, this can be given 0.5 to 1 ml per kg body weight orally every 8 hours. And then activated charcoal, administer 1 to 4 grams per kg body weight as a single dose or divided doses depending on the severity of the toxicity. Then probiotics, protexin 1 to 2 grams per 10 kg body weight, and then one can use other things like diarrhea care, lactobacillus from Himalaya 1 to 2 ml per kg body weight, and Provi Boost 5 ml per kg body weight orally once daily. Then It's important to care for the electrolyte and fluid balance. So one can administer the electrolyte powder orally, or if the condition is severe, then we have to one has to administer the electrolytes intravenously 20 to 40 ml per kg body weight. Then antimicrobial agents, metrogyl suspension, metronidazole 15 to 25 mg per kg body weight, or enrofloxacin 10% oral solution 5 mg per kg body weight, or tylosin 10 to 20 mg per kg body weight intramuscularly, or sulprim, which contains sulfamethoxazole plus trimethoprim 30 mg per kg body weight orally twice daily. But when you are administering sulfa drugs, assure that sufficient water is provided to the animals. Then kg body weight orally twice daily. It reduces the intestinal motility. However, it should be used with care in collie breeds and puppies under 6 months due to MDRI gene sensitivity.
Specific antiparasitic drugs
include tartrazuril 10 to 20 mg per kg body weight, amprolium butoconol if coccidiosis is suspected 50 mg per kg body weight orally once daily for 5 to 7 days. This treats coccidiosis in dogs. Commonly, when pups are brought to the clinician, he uses the combination of metronidazole plus norfloxacin, available commercially as gramogel syrup, and it contains 100 mg per 5 ml metronidazole and norfloxacin. Now, the typical dose for a pup would be 1 to 2 ml per kg body weight, given twice daily for 5 to 7 days. And it should be administered after food to reduce gastric irritation. Avoid these drugs in very young pups, less than 4 weeks, or dehydrated pups without IV fluids. Now, when the common problem with young pups is canine parvovirus diarrhea. And here is a list. This table shows the drugs that you should use and the name of the drug, the dosage and administration, the purpose of administration of this. And when the animal is severely ill, it should be hospitalized for 3 to 7 days, and one can use a combination of all these drugs to treat canine parvovirus. We'll be providing this presentation to you, so you can read it later on also. And one should use fluid, electrolyte therapy, antibiotics, antiemetics, GI protectants and antidiarrheals, parvovirus specific therapy and immunoboosters. So all this will help in saving your pups from the parvovirus diarrhea. So hopefully this lecture was useful, and kindly do share, kindly do subscribe to GNP Sir, kindly give your comments, give your likes, and share and subscribe. If you wish I bring more and more videos of this type on pharmacology, kindly do share and subscribe to GNP Sir. Thank you very much. See you. Bye-bye.